book this week that you're going to look at is called Wildfires. It's a National Geographic. It's a nonfiction book. So be reading for information with this book. Fire. Yellowstone National Park in Wyoming, USA, is a popular vacation spot. But in the summer of 1988, it was a danger to the public. Why? The place visited for its beautiful scenery was going up in smoke. The wildflower fire started slowly, but then they picked up speed. The park soon closed to the public. Fires burned for nearly 4 months. By the end, almost 1 million acres of park had burned. So here's a hot word. This is a vocabulary word up here. Wildflower fire. An uncontrollable fire that occurs outdoors, especially over a wooded area. Gigantic wildfires like the ones in Yellowstone don't happen very often, but they are common in wilderness areas. Some can get very large and spread quickly. They can put people and property in danger. Other fires stay small before going out on their own. After a fire, plants grow back and animals return. In fact, wildfires are an important part of nature. Up in smoke. Even the biggest wildfire starts with a single spark. A lightning strike is a common way for a fire to ignite. Volcanoes can also start fires when hot lava ignites grass or brush. Other fires start when people are careless with matches or when building fires. Here's another hot word, ignite. Oh, weird but true fact here. Lightning strikes Earth more than 100,000 times a day. A wildfire fire needs three things in order to burn: heat, fuel, and oxygen. A source of heat starts a fire and keeps it going. Heat might come from a lightning strike or a match. Fuel gives a fire the energy it needs to keep burning. Fuel can be trees, other plants, or fallen leaves. Fires also need oxygen. For fuel to burn it, it must react with oxygen in the air. So here's your hot words: fuel and oxygen. This combination of heat, fuel, and oxygen is called a fire triangle. A fire can be put out by removing any part of the triangle. Wildfires can burn in three different ways. Ground fire. A ground fire is a slow-moving fire. It burns dead, rotting leaves and the roots of plants on or in the ground. A surface fire moves along the forest floor from plant to plant. It also burns fallen leaves and branches. A crown fire spreads quickly in the tops of the trees. Winds can cause a crown fire to change direction in an instant. All three types of fire can happen in the same wildfire. So see right here, hot word, crown. Down here, weird but true fact, a wildfire can move as fast as 14 miles an hour. Wildfires happen almost anywhere in the world, but they happen most often in places with hot, dry weather. In these conditions, a spark can quickly ignite a fire. In the fall in Southern California, USA, the Santa Ana winds blow dry air from the desert over the mountains. Once a wildfire starts, the winds make the fire grow faster. Australia also has many wildfires because it is hot and dry. In parts of Australia, global winds called El Niño can cause the weather to be hotter and drier than usual. This helps fires spread. Weird but true fact, the Santa Ana winds can carry a single spark for miles. On the move. During a wildfire, animals need to protect themselves. Small animals such as frogs and turtles burrow underground. Others hide under rocks or in nearby logs until the smoke and flames have passed. Many run or fly to safety. For quick creatures such as bobcats, a fire is a great time to grab a snack. They try to catch the animals escaping the fire. Here's the word smolder, to burn slowly with smoke, but no flame. And here's some information about bugs that love fire, so make sure to read that. On the bright side, although wildfires can cause a lot of damage, they also are an important part of some ecosystems. Some forests can get so crowded with young trees that not much sunlight reaches the forest floor. This makes it hard for other plants to survive. Fires can thin out these crowded forests so that the tall trees, seedlings, and wildflowers can grow. Wildfires also help forests by burning dead leaves and plants on the ground. The ashes add nutrients to the soil, which helps plants grow. In addition, fires can remove sick plants and insects that kill trees. So there's two hot words on this page, ecosystem and nutrients. Wildfires help forests in other ways too. Some evergreen trees do not release their seeds without the extreme heat of a forest fire. During a fire, heat rises to the highest tree branches. The heat melts the waxy coating on the tree's cones. Now the cones can open and drop their seeds to the ground. After the fire, new trees can sprout in the soil. Scientists don't always understand how important wildfires are. Firefighters used to put out every wildfire, large and small, but now we know that many forests need fires to stay healthy. Some fires are allowed to burn if they are not a danger to nearby property. Sometimes fires are set on purpose to help an ecosystem. Fire managers work with firefighters to protect and help forests. They decide when an area needs a prescribed burn. Prescribed burns also remove some fuel from the area. This helps prevent extreme wildfires. Hot word on the page.